Many thanks for this opportunity. My presentation, sorry, I have to put, okay. My presentation, if it works, oh, sorry. Sorry. My presentation starts from the birth of the Italian network and its two projects financed and approved by the Ministry of Education, University and Research. The first project between 2013 and 2015 was about the network and its identity on the web. Thanks to this project, we have realized the digitization of the University Museum Cultural Heritage, experimenting the catalog card for the scientific collection in collaboration with the Ministry of Culture. And then we have realized a network bilingual web portal with eight narrative itineraries dedicated to four themes: environments, landscape, history of scientific instruments, and stories. And then, in the second project between 2016 and 2018, we use the digitized heritage for one of the most relevant goals of the university. It means educational path for lifelong guidance to the scientific method and culture. And we have realized 56 experiential paths dedicated to three main themes: biodiversity, time, color, published in the second section of the network web portal. And during the pandemic, we do other activities through digital technologies. In particular, we have realized a quarterly bilingual web magazine, University Heritage, with an enlarged network of 27 universities that is still in progress. And between 2019 and 2020, an online census of all the Italian university museums, with a detailed description of their collection and management, promoted by the Conference of the University Rectors. We, sorry, I go to the other slide. Sorry, okay. No, I'm very sorry. We start from the still deficient diffusion of scientific culture that has a significant effects on the orientation of high school students toward their succeeding higher education, as well as other essential life choices. And from the number of the graduates in scientific disciplines that, with respect to the wall of graduates, is decreasing. And the declaration of science and the use of scientific knowledge seems interesting for us, written by UNESCO in 1999. Science and knowledge must be directed to individual education, to peace, and to cultural and social and environmental development. The first project was about the identity of the museum's university network, and was about computer technologies and new realities. Oh, sorry, I have to go back. I don't know what happens. Okay, many thanks. Not me at this time. New realities for knowledge and networking and valorization of scientific cultural heritage, the role of the network of the Italian University Museums. In this project, 13 universities, 64 university museums, 38 collections, and 9 botanical gardens were involved. Okay. This project start from this portal of University Museum Network as a cultural incubator of scientific engine. The first step for the portal was the choice of the most relevant and representative themes for the University Museum's collection. It means stories, history of scientific instrument, landscape and environments. The next slide. And the second step, the choice of the most significant network museum collection, the variety of collection. Not me, at the time. I have to go back. which led to the current knowledge in various fields. Here are the 11 most representative disciplines for the objects or items that have been chosen for cataloging. And for cataloging the collection, we use the General Informative System of Catalog on the Web, issued by the Central Institute for Cataloging and Documentation of the Ministry of Culture, to realize the Italian General Catalog. And we have cataloged 28,000 objects using 17 different kinds of catalog card into the CGEC web. Here are the catalog card that we have used, and in particular, thanks to this project, we have experimented the catalog cards for the natural heritage. Thanks to this project, we have realized 80 narrative paths dedicated to the four themes, in particular 25 to the stories, 9 to the stories of the university, 19 to landscape, 18 to the environment, and 9 to the history of scientific instrument. Thanks to the web portal, you can browse the collection through the object or items catalog cards. You can visit the museum and observe the collection in its actual. Not me now. Sorry. Many thanks. You can visit the museum and observe the collection in this actual context, and also discover the area of the collection territorial provenance. So you can go through the territory of the provenance of the collections. And then, back, please. Up. Sorry. Okay, this is the slide. No. Okay. The second project between 2016 and 2018, we realized the educational path for lifelong guidance to the scientific method and culture. 11 universities, it means 47 university museums, 2 big museums, 39 collections, and 12 botanical gardens were involved in this project. In the last slide, there was the university involved in the project. The project, the principal goal was to insert the guidance to the scientific culture through the role of the university museum in the guidelines of the European Lifelong Guidance Policy Network. This was for us the most relevant goal and our challenge to realize a guiding teaching community helping to guarantee education and guidance, give youth a chance to shape their own future, prevent and oppose wastage and youth malaise, and also facilitate the acquisition of career management skills. It means those guiding skills which lead to targeted choices in line with both the students and the job market expectation. And The general goal was a prospect of integration among the competencies of the various members of the University Museum Network and also realize an integrating system for lifelong guidance able to create links, sharing, dialogues, and communication. Our protagonists were the high school students, were and are the high school students, in particular those of the last 2 years, to guide them toward the university and job market, and also high school teachers and also the students' parents and family what have to be involved in these itineraries or in this path. And cultural mediators, it means professionals who will realize and manage the project activities for which the university professor and the curator will do a special training with literature and specific experiences in the museum. The vision of our project is the guidance to the scientific method as an important task to attribute a new social role to the university museums. Educational paths with two approaches in particular, general school education, but also university education, which is highly specialized, experimental, and technically advanced. To transmit the complexity of the scientific approaches to the variety of collections related to the multiple disciplines which characterize the Italian Museum University, and also to trace back the history of the various disciplines through the study of the University Museum collection, which are representative of the historical development of the scientific research. With specific attention to the scientific method, in particular the formation and the preservation of the scientific collection as archive of knowledge built up during the centuries, and the praxis of sample experimental activities, laboratories, and stages within the fascinating context of the museum, and a development of a path from and back school through the working out of brief essays, both individual or collective, that meets the requirement of the experimental approach, in particular the rigor of method of control and reproducibility of experiments, and the distinction between result and inferences. This project is characterized by transdisciplinarity because the different disciplinary field represented by the variety of the collection allow to establish and adopt common procedures to produce several educational paths, and also to transmit to the students through museum visit and laboratorial experiences the accuracy of the scientific method which underlies every discipline, focusing on how the evaluation of researches is subjective to a precise, replicable and comparable acquisition of data. And also the variety of disciplines of Italian university museums gives account of the complexity of the scientific approach, and the university museum heritage bears witness to the historical development of the scientific researches in a lot of disciplines. Their collection help in reconstructing the history of different disciplines. And also considering that the prospect of integration among the committees of the various members of the Italian University Museum can create an integrated system for lifelong guidance able to create link sharing, dialogues and communication. This is the home page of the second section of the web portal of the network, in which you can see the three themes for which we have realized the educational path, biodiversity, color and time, and the sub-themes. And here you can see the structure of each themes that has a conceptual map, photo and video, and the possibility to browse the web portal through each path that we have realized, and in the right order, video and photos. Each path that we have realized for this second section of the web portal have the same structure, it means a conceptual map, a general objective, a specific objective, how to achieve it, the method, path articulation, path detail and description, a bibliography and also a cytography. We have realized 56 experience paths for this second section of the web portal dedicated, as you have seen before, to three themes and seven sub-themes, nine to biodiversity and agrobiodiversity, 20 to the color, nine to the color in nature, seven to the color in art, and four to the color in physics, and 27 to the time. Okay. And each path has the same structure, in particular the ways of achieving the objective through guided tour or workshop. And also we pose a lot of questions to the student, what is and why, and also the research and experiments through observation and description and analysis of the main characteristic, data analysis, conclusion, experience evaluation, and then sharing, and a production of a final document with graphic representation, photographic, multimedia, and video documentation, and then a bibliography and also a cytography. We use non-formal and informal learning for this educational path. It means to integrate and innovate the standard techniques of formal education in order to develop a new engagement to learning, in particular through the global skill. And pay specific attention to the European Council recommendation of 2018 on key competence for lifelong learning, and in particular for learning to learn competencies. It means actions to reflect on oneself identity, one's own aptitude, to manage time and information, to learn and work both collaboratively, to work constructively with others, to communicate constructively, to build trust and empathize, to express and understand different points of view, to negotiate, to focus, reflect critically and make decisions, to manage one's learning and career, to manage uncertainty, complexity and stress, to remain resilient, to promote one's physical and emotional well-being. And other recommendation about cultural awareness and expression competence. It means ability to express experience and emotion, to recognize and realize opportunity for personal, social or commercial enhancement through art and other cultural form, to engage in creative processes, both individually and collectively, curiosity about the world, openness to imagine new possibility. Using in this training pathway the ICT technology, because through this the students can become able to better stimulate and accompany the active learning processes. And at the end, we have realized the questionnaires to be delivered online to both teachers and students to check strength and weakness of educational path and also to be able to make changes and improvement for the organization of the educational path. Oh, I'm sorry. I have to come back. Okay. And we realize also a third section of the web portal with educational path dedicated to transversal skills and orientation, because a law of 2015 called the Good School of the Ministry of the University and Research, updated with an order in 2018 for the student of the last 3 years of secondary school, says that the students have to be involved with the purpose of combining the knowing and the knowing how being able to do, opening the school didactics to the external reality. And so we realize all the educational paths to engage the student in a work-like experience with a reference to the museum activities, laboratories, and professional profile who work in the field. We have dedicated the third section of our web portal to this path using the same themes of the two other sections of the web portal. It means environment, landscape, stories, history of scientific instruments, and also biodiversity, color, and time. And we realized 23 educational paths. And each path also in this section has the same structure as in for educational path of the second section. Oh, sorry. The project has a lot of results, in particular the strengthening of the Italian University Museum Network to better integrate instruction and job market through the use of the ICT technology that was fundamental during the pandemic. All this material in the website was very fundamental during the last 2 years. So we create a network for communication, it means traditional channels, new technology and web, a network of services and knowledge, and also of human resources to promote cultural and to enhance people worth. For interested subjects, not only school, university and the educative agency, but in particolar for students, educators and families. And during the pandemic, like I said before, we realized with an enlarged Italian university network of university museums, with 27 university and 40 delegates, quarterly bilingual web magazine, University Heritage, the first and currently the only one dedicated not only to university museums but also to cultural heritage in its broadest sense. The magazine is open to contributions from all professionals operating in the field of knowledge, conservation, safeguard, and promotion of cultural heritage. So you are all invited to submit us an article. Here the university involved in the project and in this bilingual magazine, and we have a lot of time for the moment, teams, for the moment 23 teams, and we are publishing the conference paper of the last SIDOC conference held in Geneva about digital transformation in cultural heritage institution. We have published the first series of papers and we are publishing other papers of the conference. And at least between 2019 and 2020, we have realized an online census of all the university museums in Italy, 97 Italian university exist, but only 41 have university museums. From this census, we realize also not only that 41 university museums have museums, but the museum existing are 125, about 25 disciplines, and 57 has 8 different typologies, as you can see. And through this online census, we know that 17 universities have museum system, 10 museum centers about their general management, and 14 are without central coordination. In this census, we pay specific attention for each museum, for staff employed, open times, educational activity, accessibility, visitor numbers, but in particular, an interesting short description of each museum with a short bibliography. Thank you for your attention.
You, I don't know, how can I see you? Ah, I think here, yeah. Thank you very much, and I'm sorry for the confusion with the slides. I hope.
No, no, it's me that sometimes
No, in the end, I think we were fine. Thank you very much for the interesting presentation. I still encourage people to enter your question to the workshop, but I have a couple of questions here. Keeping a network alive is a big job. So first question is the network now, after the project has ended, increasing, or maybe it's decreasing, or what is the situation now in 2022?
Many thanks for this question. Many thanks. The network worked a lot, as you can see, when we work at T2 project, because as you know, we had money enough and the possibility of have a lot of collaborators through this project. Now it's very difficult to work together. Sometimes you organize among us some seminars, and for this reason we decide to maintain the network, magazine, because the magazine is the real possibility not to work together really, but to stay tuned or to have information about our work. We hope that we can present other projects together, but we hope. As you know, very terrible to say, but if you haven't enough money, if you have money, it's difficult to work with particular project. And in Italy, the university museum are not financed by the Ministry of the Culture, unfortunately. So we haven't any fixed budget. Our budget depends from the budget of each university, and normally the university rector give money for a lot of initiative, and the university museum are not the first problem for our university. So it's It's difficult to work, but in any case, we continue to work. And as I said before, the magazine is the possibility to give enthusiasm to us that we maintain in any case. In particolare to work together because it's very, very interesting work together. We are really, a lot of us are really friends and we work together with very, very enthusiastic, in a very enthusiastic manner. So it was, we were friends also before, some of us, also before the network. But now is more easy. It's more easy to share information and so
Yes.
I think that a difficult work, but a good work. We have to continue to do this.
You can achieve a lot with enthusiasm, but you also need some finances to support it.
Yes.
Yes. But if the
It's a problem.
interest remains, then that is a big asset as well. I have another question here, which you, I think, touched upon a little bit. But do you measure the impact or the success of your project somehow, or what are the methods you measure that you achieved what the goals?
Yes, through this questionnaire that we have delivered to the students and also to the teacher, different teacher, normally we achieve one of the most important goal for us, it means to create interest for scientific collection. The second goal to create an interest that permit to the student to choose scientific studies for their future career. It's not easy. Perhaps I think that we have to work more, a lot and more than this. But it's sure that we have created a significant interest for the scientific culture. Also because our university museum are not regularly open to the public. So to create some communities, of sort of communities with the teacher, families and students was very important for us. Also for maintaining this interest when we realize particular events or conference on the song. So create a sort of community for us, for our museums.
That's yeah, it's very difficult. We just had recently a all conference about how to measure impact, and that's not easy.
No, not easy. We create this online questionnaires to know the impact and also their interest for this educational path, but as you know, the impact is very difficult to measure. It's a big work.
Well, thank you very much. I hope that you will have a chance to come and visit us in Tallinn at some point also.
I was here 5 years
Very good.
before. I was
Well,
6 years. Starting in Tallinn.
I also miss Italy, so
Yeah, you come. when you come.
Very good. Well, thank
I
you very much.
hope thanks to my colleagues Italian that I was
Very good. But please stay online. Sorry?
Yes, I'm in Prague. I go in Prague. I don't know if
Yes.
you come.
I will be in Prague. I will. And I think many of us here will also be here there. Yes. Very good. Well, thank you very much. Stay online. Please listen to the other presenters as well.